Hi everybody, in this video I'm going to show you how you can collect your audience's responses through a form and use that information to automate a workflow wherein you send them a personalized email that contains a NextWeave image. Moreover, I'm also going to show you how you can hyperlink this NextWeave image to a landing page that can also contain personalized experiences. So let's start by going over a few things that you would need to create before you can dive into setting up the automated workflow. The first is this Google form that I've created, which requests the audience's name as well as the business email address. We're going to use this business email address to extract the company website, which will actually be used to create our personalized templates. Now, in our demonstration, I've used a Google form. However, you can use any other form application that is compatible with your automation platform. The next thing I've done is created the templates that I would like to use in this workflow. The first is an image template. As you can see, this is personalized for the username and the domain or the company website. I've also added this little play button because I'm going to embed this image inside my email. And this will help me encourage my audience to click on this image and hyperlink them to a video landing page. Similar to this image, I have also created a second image template that I'm going to use as my thumbnail for my video. So this is actually going to appear as an overlay on the video before my audience presses play. And lastly, I've created this NextWeave video that once again is personalized for the name and the company website of my audience or my recipient. You can have a look at our help documentation as well as video tutorials for detailed guides on how you can use NextWeave to create personalized images and videos such as this. And the last thing I've created for this workflow is this personalized landing page. So as you can see, this landing page contains videos as well as images that have been created on NextWeave and contain personalization elements. So as you can see, my name appears in the different images that are here. And the hero video on this landing page is actually the same as the video from our NextWeave template. Once again, you can have a look at our help documentation for detailed articles on how you can use the website personalization plugin as well as campaigns to create personalized landing pages such as this. So to recap, what this automated workflow is going to do is collect audience responses through this Google form. And in response to this form, it is going to share a personalized email that contains this image, which is going to be personalized for the name of the domain. And when an audience member clicks on this, when a recipient clicks on this image, they're going to be redirected to this landing page that contains a video that is personalized for them as well. Now let's proceed by creating a campaign to tie all these personalization pieces together and make these templates available to use on our automation platform. So within the main menu, click on campaigns and then click on create new campaign. You can set a name for your campaign. Now since we intend to use both an image and a video template for our personalization workflow, we're going to leave the campaign type as video plus image. And then proceed to select the templates. So in my example, I'm just selecting the templates I showed you in the last few seconds. I've selected an image template, a video template, as well as another image template that's going to be used as a thumbnail for the video. Now focus on the landing page URL. In this situation, I want to actually redirect my audience to a landing page that I've created. So this is a custom landing page. So what I'm going to do is, under landing page URL, I will set this to custom landing page and then enter the domain name. So as you can see, the domain here is nextwave.com. Everything else is going to be added to this domain throughout the campaign process, as you'll see in the next few steps. Once your campaign is configured, just click on save and proceed. You can choose any of the available activation methods here and refer to our help documentation and video tutorials to learn about the two activation methods that are available. For this demonstration, I'm going to stick to URL override campaign. Leave the fallback or default values as they are and just click on save. So now this campaign is ready to be launched. All I need to do now is click on launch campaign. So this campaign process is done. When you navigate to your automation platform, you'll now be able to call on this campaign and effectively on the templates for personalization. So let's now move to our automation platform. So for this workflow, I'm using Fably Connect to set up the automation. However, you can use any other compatible platform to create your automation as well. Click on Create Workflow and enter the workflow name. Set your first application to Google Form and the trigger event to New Response in Spreadsheet. As you can see, the steps to connect Google Forms to Fably is exactly the same as that of Google Sheets. This is because all the Google Form responses have been configured so that they automatically flow through to this Google Sheet. And I've also entered a sample response here, which will be used to test the automation on Fably. You can follow the listed steps to connect your relevant Google Sheet with Fably. Once you connect your Google Sheets with Fably, a test response will be sent from the sheet to Fably. This is why it's important for you to have at least one response from the form captured in your Google Sheet. So as you can see, the response collected here is the same as the first row within my Google Sheet. Now that we've configured the Google Form part of the automation, let's move on to the next step. As you can see in the image template we're using as well as the video template, both of them take two variables, which is the username and the domain or the company website. The Google Form I've created requests the respondent's first name as well as the business email ID. So in the next step in the Fably workflow, we need to extract the domain or the company website from the business email ID. So set the application in the next step within Fably to text formatter and the action event to split text. Once this is authorized, certain fields will be listed below. In the first field, we need to enter the text that we want to split. So this is going to be the email address that is collected from the Google Form. So you can just select that as a response from the Google Form step. The next is the separator. So in this case, as you can see, the business email address is split into two parts. Show that to you. It's shreya@nextweave.com. So what we want is everything after the @ sign. So I'm going to set the separator here to @, which is a special character. And the segment index, which is the segment of this particular text that I want to extract, is going to be the second part of it. So this will extract everything after the @. And now let's save and send test request to see what is the response we receive from this. So you can see here the result is nextweave.com. So with the text formatter step in Fably, we've effectively extracted the domain or the company website from the business email address. Let's proceed to the next step. Now that we've collected and formatted all the information we need to personalize our templates, you can go ahead and set the next application to NextWave and set the action event to create experience with campaign. Click on connect to connect your NextWave account with Fably. If you've done this before, you can see all your previous connections by clicking on choose existing connection. However, if you are new to this workflow, then click on add new connection. When you do, you'll be prompted to enter an API key. To generate that key, you can navigate to your NextWave account and go to the integration section. Now, all you need to do is click on add key, set a name for the key, and add key again. And automatically an API key will be generated. You can simply copy this key, go back to Fably, and paste it here. And click on save to complete. So once your NextWave session or NextWave login is connected with Fably, all the campaigns that you've used in that login will be available for you to choose from. So I'm going to select the campaign form to email to LP demo, which is a campaign that I created in the beginning of this demonstration. As soon as I select the campaign, the variables that have been used in the templates within the campaign appear below. So as I've already shown you before, I have common variables in both of my templates, username and domain, so they will appear here. And now what we need to do is map these with the data that is coming in from the Google Forms. So simply click on the username field here and then insert here the data coming from the what is your first name question within the Google Form. We can follow a similar step for the domain as well. However, now instead of directly selecting a response from the Google Form, I need to select the result from the text formatter. This is because what the text formatter is doing is extracting the domain information from the business email ID. So in this sample, essentially the username is being mapped to what is your first name, which is Shreya in my test response, and the domain, which is nextwave.com in my test response. You can click on save and test request to see if this is working the way it's supposed to. So a video link, thumbnail link, and image link is generated in the test response. And I'm just going to show you what this video link looks like. So you can open this in a new tab, and this is going to be the landing page, the custom landing page that I created and where I embedded my personalized video. And it's going to be personalized to the name Shreya as well as the domain nextweek.com. So you can see here my name appearing and Shreya and nextweek.com, and within the video as well. So the next few steps has been completed. We've invoked the campaign as well as generated the personalized links that contain the landing page, the image link, etc. In the next step, we're going to add these to the email. So let's proceed. In the final step of this workflow, add your email application through which you want to send personalized emails to your respondents. I'm going to select Gmail here and set the action event to send an email. Now, if you've never done this before, you can click on Add New Connection. However, I'm just going to select one of my previous connections to save time. All the required fields will be listed below. So you can go ahead and map the recipient name to the name collected from the Google form. Similarly, map the recipient email address to the email collected from the Google form. I'm setting the sender name to Team Nextweek. The sender email to connected@nextweek.com. So this is the email address that I've connected Fabry to as well. I'm going to leave the reply to email address as blank for now. Next, I'm going to set the email subject. And you can personalize this by once again inserting data from one of the previous, from the data collected from the form. So I'm just going to set this to Hey First Name. And lastly, we need to enter the email content. So this is where we're going to be plugging in the image link, the video link, etc. that is generated from Nextweave as well. So I have this pre-created email script. So I'm just going to copy and paste this into my Fabry workflow, and let's just format it a little bit. Now I've added the static email content, but in order to personalize this, I'm basically going to replace some of the information with the fields that we've generated or data we've collected from the previous steps of the workflow. So instead of the value hey name, I'm going to insert the name response to the Google form. Similarly, in place of this video link option, I'm going to select the video link response from the next week step. And similarly, in place of the image link text there, I'm going to insert the image link response from the Google form. So this is how you can embed. We need to use this HTML code to embed a Nextweave image which is the image link generated inside our email, and hyperlink it to the video landing page. So I've used this email embed code, and I've just selected the video link and image link values that were received from the NextWave step. Once your email has been generated, once your email is formatted and created, all you need to do is click on Save and Send Test Request. If you receive a response like this, it means the response was a success and your workflow has been set up correctly. From a recipient's perspective, they will see an email like this, which if they expand, will be personalized for their name in the text. And they'll also see an image and see the company website, screenshot, the logo, as well as their name. And they can click on this to access their very own landing page as well. So this brings us to the end of this video. Please ensure that your workflow status is enabled or kept to on. And within the Google Sheet or Google Form that is connected to Pabbly, under Add-ons and Connect, Pabbly Connect Webhooks, the Send On Event action is checked. So each time there is a new response, this will automatically add it to the Google Sheet and automatically trigger your Pabbly workflow. As always, please do have a look at our help documentation and our video tutorials to find all there is to know about NextWave, and participate in our Facebook community to share more ideas for use cases that we can cover for you. Have a great day.